Let's see what the flag is going to be. That's number 5, Chancey Simpson on the receiving end of that touchdown. Rather, number 5, Jason Cook on the receiving end of that touchdown. We do have the flag, and I've not yet seen it in patient yet. But it's going to be an offside call against the Gordon Longhorns, so we do have a touchdown. A touchdown for the Windmill Panthers. And so with 8 minutes and 6 seconds to go, the Panthers are on the board first tonight. Off to attempt the extra point right now is Brandon Rogers. Ball is marked at the 10-yard line. We'll have to move it all over the place. The flag flies before the ball is even snapped. Either the Longhorns were offside or they were drawn offside, I suppose. We have to wait and see what the official indication is. It's going to be an offside call again against the Longhorns, and they are perhaps a bit eager early in this ball game. Randy, you know, there's some butterflies out there.
Definitely, and you can see that, especially the defensive movement. They're trying to get back there too quickly. You can kind of settle down, get the bearings about, and play some football.
Here we go, there's the snap. The kick is up, it's short, and it goes to the left. The kicker plays down a pass from Michael Lopez to Jason Cook, who starts this ball game off here today at the six-man state football championship. With Harold 6, Gordon nothing. 8 minutes, 6 seconds to go in the first quarter. And Gordon should have their first opportunity to touch the ball. There's an onside kick. It's all moved on to 30. And Davis is recovered by Whittell. It has been an onside kick. Then the Gordon Longhorns would go by the 30-yard line and comes to the going down a bounce grip. Has been recovered by Whit Harold. Unbelievable. You can see in a while the battle they were going to do. Gordon left the ball behind them. Didn't really go through the ball quick enough. They had a play catch-up game, and now the Longhorns are going to have to back against the ball. No way to say what there.
My goodness, what a chain of events here early in the first quarter. Whit Harold going to get the football first and 15. And the ball is at the Gordon 25-yard line from the spread formation. Quarterback Justin Springer has the ball. He finds out what it is. That pump is deep downfield. It's caught. It's caught for a touchdown. Unbelievable. Oh, my God. The Longhorns had a shot at him at about the 30. He avoided that and tossed the ball deep into the end zone. And Godfrey comes up with it. There was some good coverage in the end zone by Joe Cosia, but the pass was absolutely perfect. And this is a very unfamiliar situation for the Gordon Longhorns.
There is a play of game five out here. Gordon can get out of his hole. There's the snap, the kick, the extra point attempt again. Wide five. That may be a good open, let's say, for the Gordon Longhorns. The Twin Barrel has been unable to convert on either of their extra point attempts thus far. So our new score, with just 7 minutes 56 seconds to go in the first quarter, is now Whit Harold 12 and Gordon nothing. And Redmond season right here is one of the interesting things we've been watching for just the last 2 minutes. The wind is trying to change directions here. We had a southerly breeze up until game time. It looks now, it's difficult to tell where the whole situation, of course, which has been swirling, but it looks like that wind may be switching around to a westerly direction, eventually to the northerly side. So we'll follow that as the game goes on. Here's another onside hit by Whit Harold. This time it's recovered by Gordon inside their own territory at about the 39-yard line. Jim Garcia picked that up right at the 39-yard line. Nice heads-up move for Gordon. And again, the lineup of the offside kick formation are totally confusing there. The Gordon Longhorns at that time, hey, did a great job of picking it up. Gordon has some fantastic athletes. That's going to be put on that very first line to make sure the offside is in line again.
So that was the part of Gordon Crowd is ready to see some offensive action from their side of the field. And Cosia brings this man up to the line of scrimmage, a tight formation, side form the backfield. Cosia going to throw it over to the after receiver Chamberlain at the 25-yard line. And just overthrows him. Looks like Chamberlain may have had some problems getting off the line of scrimmage, and that's what this Gordon Crowd field sounded. Since we have a huge contention from the city of Gordon, I don't know who they left behind in the store in Gordon, Texas, for that matter, it's Whit Harold. But in any case, just about everybody is here. We have a great crowd here at Mustang Bowl.
Some people were making fun of us earlier from broadcasting Gordon. What do we have? All fans that are Gordon fans, back to General Wells, Westbrook, number 2nd and 15.
There's a big back to side, so he changes directions, but it's onside.